हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज योर फिफ्थ लेक्चर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर सिस्टम टू। लास्ट वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द अल्फा ऑपरेटर, हाउ टू यूज द अल्फा ऑपरेटर टू कन्वर्ट द अनबैलेंस सिस्टम वेरिएबल्स लाइक वोल्टेज एंड करंट इनटू द बैलेंस वेरिएबल। ओके, सो टुडे वी सी वन एग्जाम्पल। इन दिस एग्जाम्पल वॉट इज द स्टेटमेंट? In a balanced three-phase circuit, the voltage VAB, what is the value of VAB? 173.2 at an angle of 0 degree volt. Determine all the voltages and currents in the star connected load having ZL is equal to 10 at the rate 20 degree ohm. Phase sequence is ABC. Okay, so how we can calculate ask in the statement, determine all the voltages and currents in a star connected load. Okay, so here we have a load which value is ZL is equal to 10 at an angle of 20 degree ohm. Okay, so first convert the line to line voltage. Okay, so VAB is equal to, what is the formula? Under root 3 VAN at the rate 30 degree. Okay, so if we want to calculate VAN from the line voltage, then how can we calculate? Divide this line voltage with the under root 3 at an angle of 30 degree. So we got the phase value. Okay, so after that we can calculate VBC and how we can calculate VBC? VBC is equal to under root 3 VAN. VAN is a phase voltage, okay, at an angle of 270 degree. So we can calculate all the values VAB, VAC and VCA. Okay, then line to neutral voltage. So how can we calculate line to neutral voltage? Simple. VBN is equal to alpha square VN. Now we have a alpha operator. Okay, so we have one phase voltage VAN. So by using this phase voltage, we can calculate other phase voltages. Okay, VBN and VCN. You have to memorize this formula for the phase voltages. VBN is equal to alpha square VAN and VCN is equal to alpha into VAN. Okay, so put all the values. What is the value of alpha square? One at angle of 240 degree, and we have a value of VAN 100 and minus 30 degree. Okay, so we got the value VBN. Okay, just like this, and then we got the value like VCN. VCN value of VCN is, okay, let me take a marker. Okay, so this is the value of VCN, and value of VCN is alpha into VAN, and put the value of alpha and VAN, you got the value of VCN. Then we have a line to neutral currents. Okay, so how we can calculate the current? Simple. From the Ohm's law, if you want to calculate our current, then we can simply calculate by using the Ohm's law. I is equal to V upon impedance. Okay, voltage upon impedance. So here we want to calculate, IAN, and which is a VAN divided by ZL. Okay, so we have a ZL load, a star connected load. So put all the values VAN divided by ZL, and we get the VIAN value. Similar, we can calculate the VBN value and VCN value. Okay, so here it is a phasor representation of all the currents and voltages. So look at that. This is the reference point. Here we have a VAN. So how can we mark in the graph? Okay, so what is the value of VAN? 100 at an angle of minus 30 degree. Okay, so if we have take the reference here, if we take this reference, okay, so from this reference we have to move minus 30 degree. Okay, so in minus 30 degree means in a clockwise direction, minus 30 degree, we have a VAN. And what is the value of IAN? here we have a value of IAN 10 at an angle of minus 50 degree. Okay, so minus 50 degree again, it is from reference to in clockwise direction, total one, 50 degree, and from the voltage VAN, we it is a 20 degree. Okay, so we mark this at here. Then we have another four two voltages and two currents. Okay, VBN, what is the value of VBN? Here we have a value of VBN 100 at an angle of 210 degree. Okay, so now we have a positive angle. So from positive, we this is the what is this angle? This is a 210 degree angle. Okay, so you can calculate like this. Here to here we have a 90 degree, another 90 degree here. Okay, so total 180 degree. Then how much remaining? 210 minus 180, 30 degree. So from here we have to move 30 degree to get the VBN. Okay, then we have a value of VBN. What is the VBN? IAN, IBN. What is the value of IBN? Value of IBN is a 10, which is an amplitude, and its angle is 190 degree. Okay, so 190 degree. Where we mark this 190 degree? This is a 180 degree, and remaining is a 20 degree. So here from this axis 20 degree. Okay, so we have a IBN. Let me erase. Okay, so last we have a VCN. Okay, so similarly we can mark on the graph. Okay, then a star connected load, what is the difference in a star and delta connected loads? So in star connected load, starting ends or finishing ends of three coils are connected together. It is a simple statement for the star connected load. Then common connection point is called a star or a neutral point. Okay, this is a star connected load. Okay, so in this star connected load, read again these two statement: starting ends or finishing end. Okay, or not end. Okay, starting ends or finishing ends of three coils are connected together. Okay, so here we have a starting ends, which are our phase connection. Okay, and these are our source connection. Okay, this is a load, so it needs a source. Okay, this terminal are open for the source connection. Okay, and another terminals means we can say finishing ends are connected together to form the star connection. Okay, and this common point is known as a star or a neutral point. Okay, so this is a star connected load. All the voltages and currents are marked. You can see this is a phase A. Okay, so in phase A we have a line current IA, and in star connection always remember the value of line and phase current are always same. So IAN, I line is equal to I phase. Okay, similar. Then we have a voltage, phase voltage VAN. Okay, similarly all the other phase like B and C also have a currents, line currents and a phase voltage. Okay, so we have another three voltages which is called a line voltage. Okay, between the line or between two lines. So we have a first voltage, we have a VAB, which is between the phase A and phase B. Okay, so it is a VAB. And this VAB is different from the phase voltage. Phase voltage. What is the phase voltage? VAN, VBN, and VCN. So values of line voltage and phase voltage are different. Don't mess up with this. Don't equalize both the terms. Okay, both are different altogether. So VAB, and then we have another two voltage, VBC and VCA. So these are the line voltages. Then line similarly all the explanation are written here, so you can simply read and what is the line currents here, line and phase current are same, okay, so all the terms are marked, but we have a voltages are different, okay, so voltage, how can we relate this line and phase voltages? So here we have a simple, and this is a line voltage VAB. So how this VAB form? VAN minus VBN, okay, so VAN minus VBN, how to calculate this VAN minus VBN, because this is not a directly algebraic difference, okay, this is a vector difference. So mark my point, mark my words, this is a vector difference, okay, not a algebraic difference. So you cannot directly subtract from the VN, VBN from the VN, okay, so you have to take the vector difference. And how can we take this vector difference? So here, look at that, look at this formula, let me take a marker here, VAB, okay, VAB is a, what is the formula? VAN square plus VBN square plus 2 VAB and VBN cos theta. Now, what is the cos theta? Cos theta is the angle between the VAN and VBN. Okay, so this angle is, you can take this angle from the phasor diagram. If you have, if you given a phasor diagram, if you have given a phasor diagram, then you can directly take from this. Or if you have a values of VAN and VBN, then in the values clearly mention the phasor angle. At the red angle, okay, so you can take this different difference from the VAN and VBN, and this difference is your theta, okay, not cos theta, this is only a theta, and then put this theta with the cos, then you will get a cos theta, okay, so this is the formula to take the vector difference, okay, so whenever you want to calculate the phase line current from the phase voltages, then phase line voltages from the phase voltages, then use this formula. Do not directly take the algebraic sum, because it will be wrong, okay, so take this formula and calculate your voltages, okay, then then similarly we have a delta connected load. This is a delta connected load. In this delta connected load, starting end of one coil is connected to the finishing end of other phase coil. Okay, closed circuit is formed. Okay, here closed circuit is formed. Starting end of one coil is connected to the finishing end of other coil. Okay. So you can see what is the difference between the star and delta connected. Here we have a line voltage and phase voltage are same, okay, like the star connection, okay, in star connection we have a currents are similar, phase and line, but here we have a voltage are similar, okay, so but here your currents are different, okay, so line current and phase current are different. So how can we calculate? So these are the this is the explanation, okay, so similarly in we have to take the vector difference of the currents, okay, so if you want to calculate the line current, then take the vector difference of IA phase and IB phase, okay, these are the phase currents, okay, so calculate just like the voltages, you can calculate this, okay. Also always remember, you do not have to all the time this formula. If you given if you not given any phase voltage and you phase voltage or a current in respective star or delta connection, then you have to take this whole formula and calculate all the value. But if you directly given the phase current, okay, and you asked to find the line current, okay, so use this formula. This formula directly give the line current, or if you have a star connected load, then directly it will give the voltage, okay, line voltage from the phase voltage. So this is a star and delta connected loads, how can you transform from star to delta and delta to star? This is a simple, you already studied the in basic electronics or basic electrical, how to convert the star connection into delta and delta to star. So again, we go through this topic. Single phase or four phase equivalent circuit is used for calculation. Balanced delta connected load is replaced by its equivalent star connected load for calculation. So in this sentence, one word is very, very important, and it is a balanced. Okay, what the meaning of this balanced? Okay, balance is meaning that your all the loads are in equal value. Okay, equal value. Equal value means all the values of Z is equal, it is not a variable, means it takes the same current and same voltage difference across it. Okay, then this is the balanced word. So if you have balanced delta, then you can convert it into the balanced star, or if we have balanced star, then you can convert it into balanced delta. But balance is a very, very necessary. Okay, so how can you calculate? And this is the first star into delta transformation. So if we have a star connection, okay, if you have a star connection, this is our star connection, okay, and this dotted line show the respective, or you can say the conversion of the star into delta. So what you require to calculate here, you want first ZAB, okay, so you have the all the variables delta of star connection. Okay, so from these variables you can calculate this, like what is the formula of ZAB? ZAB is the branch of delta connection, okay, conversion from star to delta. Then ZAB is equal to ZA into ZB. What is Z and ZB? ZA and ZB is the branches of this star connection. Okay, Z into ZB, ZB into ZC, and ZC into ZA divided by ZC. Okay, so I will give you one short trick, because this is the formula, many formulas are there, so you don't need to mug up all this. I will give you one shortcut so you can easily find out what is this star and delta connection. Okay, so how we can judge which variable is come or which variable is not come? Okay, so look at that. If you want to calculate, okay, if you want to calculate this ZAB, okay, so what is the in front of ZAB? It is a ZC. So if you want to calculate ZAB, then this ZC is come under the, okay, this ZC is come divide in division, okay, ZC. And what comes in the upper part of this division? So this part is same for all, okay, for all these conversion, this part is same. You can look ZA into ZB plus ZB into ZC. So this term is common for all the formulas. Okay, so you don't need to mug up this type of what is the come in the division. Okay, so simply if you want to calculate ZAB, then what is the in front of this ZAB is ZC. So simply divide this ZC. Okay, and this is the common, Z into ZB, ZB into ZC, ZC into ZA. So this is the same for all the formulas. And if you want to calculate this ZBC, okay, this ZBC, then what is the in front of this ZBC? ZA. So divide it by ZA. So you can simply get this ZBC. So similarly, you can remember all this formula for from star to delta transformation. Similarly, if you have a impedance, then use this formula. But if you have a admittance, then formula is different. Okay, formula will change. What is this formula? YAB. If you have a impedance, you can see here in a bracket all the impedance are shown. Okay, so now consider that you don't have any impedance, you have a admittance. Okay, and this admittance is a reciprocal of impedance. Okay, so how can you calculate YAB? So to calculate the YAB, another I will give you another short trick for admittance. So look at that. If you want to calculate YAB, okay, then what is the upper part? You can see here in upper part YA into YB. So you can see what is this is the YAB and what is the nearby two admittance YA and YB. So multiply both and put it into the upper part of division. Okay, and similarly, yeah, in the division part, in the lower part, this formula is same for all. Okay, this term is same for all. YA plus YB plus YC. Okay, so put these common terms and what is the upper part? Upper part, only upper part will be different in each formula. Okay, so what for YBC? This is a YBC. Then what is the nearby two admittance? YB and YC. Okay, so put this YB and YC. Or I will give another short trick. Let me erase. Okay, so you can see what if you want to calculate YA and YB. Okay, YAB. Okay, then definitely this term A and B is come here. Okay, so you don't need to see what is the nearby admittance. Okay, simply put YA and YB. Similarly, YB and YC, you can put directly YB and YC. Okay, in upper part and lower part is common for all. Okay, so similarly, you can also convert this delta connection into star. Okay, formula is different. Quite different. Okay, so in this formula you want to calculate star equivalents. Okay, so what is this star equivalent? Za. Okay, so Za is calculated by, so here also you have a one short trick. In Za, what is the here Za, what is the upper part? ZAB and ZCA. So this is the nearby admittance. Okay, so what is the nearby admittance? Two admittance, ZAB and ZCA. Okay, and lower part is common for all. Okay, similarly you can apply this for a admittance calculation. Okay, so try once or two times this is only a formula. Okay, so take a numerical value and calculate some star to delta transformation and delta to star transformation. So your this concept is clear in your mind. Okay, so if you have any doubt up to this point, then comment it down and write your enrollment number in the comment box so that it will count as your attendance. Okay, thank you.